Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 595, and today's topic is the medicinal chemistry of depression. When I am saying chemistry of depression, it looks very unusual, because what impression people are having about the depression, that it is more related to connection, social relation, emotion, and lot of other genetic factor, biological factor, but nobody thinks about the chemical aspect, that is the neurochemistry, medicinal chemistry of our brain. Actually, the concept of depression was never recognized as a medical disease for many years. Only in 1960s, WHO started recognizing that this mental disorder, depression, anxiety, unipolar disorder, means for long time sadness, is actually a disease. And people are saying that this depression is 21st century a disease, because of lot of chasing to your ambition, to your desire, to money, stress and strain, greed, social disturbance. No, it's not like that, because we are all made up of molecules, and these molecules are in the form of cells, that is genetic material, protein, carbohydrate, fat, and the same human beings were having the same material even thousands of years ago. So it was existing. Depression was always there. I can recall my childhood in India, especially. I don't know about Africa or Nigeria. They were linking the hysteria, or higher case and lower case of status of depression, means some your energy is high, so they may be violent or they may be aggressive. And somewhere the energy is low, mental energy, brain energy, then they are in sadness, they are sitting inside isolation in their rooms. So this, state of mental disorder, depression, will link to some supernatural thing, Satan, Jinnat, Churail, this and that, because they were not able to understand that some chemistry is involved. Neurochemicals are there. Dopamine is playing role. Serotonin is playing role. Phenylethylamine is playing role. They are depleted. They are deficient. Some estrogens, sex hormones, female sex hormone progesterone, testosterone, or hormonal impact is also there. For example, in the beginning it was identified that actually depression is a female disease, because 90% female are affected, and that female were affected because of two factors, that is because of their menstrual cycle and pregnancy. During that time, the level of female sex hormone, that is called progesterone, and in general estrogens, they used to fall, deplete. And in that case, their mood swing was there. Sadness was there. They were always in isolation. They were not feeling happy. So it was identified with female because of pregnancy, because of menstrual cycle. And now we understand that it is all chemistry, medicinal chemistry. So there are some foods, they are rich in phytosterol, structurally related compound to all these steroids. If it is given to them, to those female, they can bind with those, which are in deficient, and then they can maintain the level. So if those female, they are always keeping on some good selected fruit and vegetables, where phytosterols are there, they can maintain. and they will not be subjected to such type of mental disorder that is called depression. Now today, in Asia and Africa, there is misconception of happiness and depression. They have the concept, impression, that anybody who is very rich, affluent, prosperous, everything is available, lot of money is there, is all the ingredient for happiness, is wrong. There is chemistry. Even if you give everything, in Western countries, they are very rich. Their lifestyle is of very good quality. Everything is available. Still, the rate of depression is more there. Western countries, even in Asian countries like Japan, in spite of the fact that everything is there, people, they commit suicide because of chronic depression. So money is not the only factor. Prosperity, affluency, your power, your success. No, it's all temporary. Once these chemicals are in action, means they are depleted, they are deficient in our brain, in our body, whatever prosperity we have, there is chance of depression. So we should not ignore the factor of these chemicals. And nowadays, again, another stigma is there in Asian and African countries, that if suppose I am going to consult any consultant who is dealing with mental health related problem or psychiatric, if the neighbors will come to know, my status will be less, my position will be less. And sometimes I may lose job, that okay, he's consulting psychiatric. It's very, very wrong. It's a disease. Just like cancer, just like diabetes, just like hypertension, cardiovascular. This also, chemistry is involved, is also disease. To take it like that, please, we should come out of such type of social stigma that I should hide it. Whatever mental status is there, mentally we are sick because of the hormonal disturbance, because of the dopamine fall, because of the serotonin fall, because of the phenylethylamine fall in our body. And rather than to boost, even it can be boosted by even our lifestyle, by selective fruit and vegetables and some mind medication. And the second factor I am giving, that many people, they have this concept that no, I will not go to antidepressant chemicals, they are toxic, they are, will be addicted, is wrong concept. We should know what is difference in addiction and need. Addiction means where you don't need smoking of cigarette and you are smoking 10 or 20 cigarettes every day. That is addiction, because you don't need. You don't require for your health. These things, serotonin, dopamine, phenylethylamine, amitriptyline, they are there to boost your nitrogenous compound in your brain. So it is a treatment. You should understand very well. But for example, we are managing our diabetic condition, those who are suffering from metabolic process. Means in blood, hyperglycemia means lot of extra glucose molecules are there, and because of that, they have the health problem, and enough insulin is not there to break down into energy. So we are taking medicine, we are taking insulin, and after taking those medication, insulin and tablets, we are also taking care of lifestyle. We are doing exercise, we are selective, we are not taking any refined sugar. So these are all just like any other disease. So if suppose you have depletion of these organic compounds, nitrogenous compounds, amino compounds, which are playing very important role as a neurotransmitter, as a neuro messenger, as a mood booster, to control your mood, to control your function, to control your behavior, to get away from depression, you should continue as a treatment. Medication is not addiction. It's wrong. I mean, there is no reason. And why I am saying this? I was going through one publication by WHO, and they mentioned that in coming decades, more than 20% female will commit suicide because of depression. And lot of male affluent, very successful, they are committing suicide, they are depressed. And latest example, why I am delivering this lecture, because it happened in India last week. One very fine actor, he was scientist also. He was topper, excellent genius. He committed suicide and he was 34 year old. He was having everything, good house, good car, good food, good money. But big question mark, he committed suicide because he was under chronic depression. And he never told to his neighbors, to his parents, to his friends. And he was in total self-isolation. Don't go for self-isolation. Connectivity with your friends, with your relatives, with your loved one will reduce drastically this condition, and that will give the chance of increasing the production of all these chemicals in your body and in your brain, and you will be highly protected. So these are very important factors, and there are some symptoms. We have to identify those symptoms. Like people say, if you go to anybody, educated person, they will say only one thing. Go for exercise. Go for walking. Go for gathering. All these talking will be there. So actually, I am going to continue the other half of the lecture because of time factor in second part. So thank you very much for watching the lecture.